Like and subscribe down, or you're gonna have bad luck this week.
Zoos are pretty controversial places. Keeping wild animals caged has its own set of unique drawbacks, especially when the spectators themselves aren't too bright. But sometimes zoos just aren't able to keep their animals locked up. Since the modern zoo came into being nearly a century ago, crazy zoo escapes have been a fixture of society. Sometimes the animals are bored of captivity and make a daring escape. Other times they just jump over the fence to stroll around in the city. Today, we're going to look at some of the craziest cases of animals who escaped from the zoo. Let's begin. Sneaky red panda. They're known for mostly lazing about during the day with their fur-covered bodies stretched over tree limbs. But one red panda at the National Zoo in Washington, D.C. wasn't spotted in his normal habitat. In fact, he decided to escape and have a walk in the city. So the zoo took to Twitter to recruit the public's help, accompanying a photo of the small woodland creature were the vitals, a missing red panda, a male named Rusty. He was last seen at 6 p.m. last night. Zookeepers wouldn't even reveal just how the panda escaped or even if it left the premises. The @NationalZoo Twitter account kept loyal red panda watchers up to date on the search for Rusty. As a word of the search quickly spread, DC residents vigilantly looked out for the adorable animal, which resembles a cross between a bear and a raccoon. In the early afternoon, a photo of Rusty scampering through a residential neighborhood was posted on Twitter. Given the rarity of red pandas, it was very likely Rusty. Within the hour, animal control teams had captured him and put him in a crate, promptly helping him back to the zoo. The red panda has little in common with its giant black and white cousins aside from common Chinese heritage. But Rusty hails from Nebraska, arriving in DC 2 months ago. His impromptu tour of his new city has come to a safe end. Trio of mischiefs. The thing about being a zookeeper is that you're really effective only if you're able to keep the animals in the zoo. In July 1964, a zookeeper at the Flash Hiker Zoo, which is now the San Francisco Zoo, had a really bad day. First, he got a call from the police saying they had captured 13 buffalo that zoo director Carrie Baldwin didn't even know they were missing. 5 hours later, he received another call. This time again, a 300-pound, 135-kilogram pygmy hippopotamus had escaped and was taking a stroll down a nearby road. If you think that's where it would stop, you'd be wrong. A short while later, a large South American rodent called Aguidi made a run for it. A dramatic chase ensued, and the little guy was eventually captured. At the end of his day, the guy told the Associated Press he would review the zoo security. Lion. In 2015, a lion managed to escape a Chinese zoo. A maintenance worker, aged 65 years old, was used to working inside the lion's cage and was not afraid. However, one day he turned his back to the lion and it threw itself on the man, pulling away from his shoulders and a part of his neck. The man died from his injuries. The gate remained open and the lion escaped. Staff and visitors were then evacuated, but the lion was shot so it wouldn't pose another risk. Unfortunately, not all these stories have a happy ending. Inmate number 337. Now, I don't know about you, but I find it demeaning when prison guards start calling inmates by their numbers and not by their names. I mean, yeah, they're crooks, but they're still humans. Well, most of them, at least. It seems that animal inmates don't appreciate this, too. In 2012, a Humboldt penguin, only referred to as Penguin 337, managed to scale a wall and squeeze through a hole in the fence of the Tokyo Sea Life Park. It then remained at large in Japan's capital city for nearly 2 months before it was recovered. Perhaps most surprisingly, 337 was able to survive in the city relatively unscathed. When he was spotted and recovered, a spokesman for the Tokyo Sea Life Park said the penguin was in good health and he even managed to hunt successfully, maintaining its weight throughout the ordeal. Well, this is Japan after all. Fish actually thrive in their drainage system, so it's not surprising that 337 found a lot to eat. Flamingo fun. In 2005, an African flamingo made a break from a zoo in Kansas. Though a search was organized to find the little guy, it was to no avail. The flamingo had gone missing. Until 8 years later, that is, when birdwatcher Neil Hayward spotted the flamingo 650 miles away on Texas's Gulf Coast. Apparently, the flamingo had migrated to the ocean and found himself a partner who'd escaped from a Mexican nature reserve years earlier. When notified of their bird's existence, the Kansas Zoo wished the flamingo luck and stated they'd allow the bird to continue living in the wild. I wish the zoo said the same for every animal living in captivity and not just the ones who escaped under their noses. The unusual tourist. What is the best way to gain 160,000 Twitter followers in an instant? Well, if you're an animal locked up in a zoo, it seems escaping would be the best way to go about it. For a period of 6 days in 2011, an Egyptian cobra from the Bronx Zoo slithered out from its confines and sparked a city-wide manhunt. Of course, the reptile's keepers insisted that the cobra couldn't have gone far the entire time it was on the run. It turns out they were right, as it was found just a few hundred feet from her enclosure, safe and sound. Quite expectedly, the escape was big news among New Yorkers. One social network savvy individual even put up a Twitter account for the escaped serpent that gained 160,000 followers in just a few days. I mean, who wouldn't follow a snake on the lam whose Twitter profile begins with the words, "I want to thank those animals from the movie Madagascar. They were a real inspiration." Crocodiles. In 2017, around a dozen crocodiles managed to escape from a Thailand zoo during heavy flooding. How did they manage to get loose? Well, after all, they are pretty slow creatures and aren't very discreet. However, the heavy rainfall and flooding came to their aid. While locals were trying to protect themselves from the flooding, they were also faced with the threat of a dozen escaped crocodiles. In summary, there were 18 deaths, which don't include those lost due to the heavy flooding. Tiger hunt. India is one of the few countries in which tigers still thrive, although the numbers have been declining at an alarming rate over the years. The country has these big cats in zoos and out in the wild. Most tigers will be glad to be out there fending for themselves rather than being gawked at in enclosures. But in 2013, a male tiger gleefully strolled into the Nandankanan Zoological Park in a completely unexpected turn of events. Before the entry, the tiger had been wandering around the zoo for months before zoo officials decided to open the gates to let him in. Naturally, everyone at the zoo was concerned about the whole situation, so the male tiger was closely monitored with high-resolution cameras. But nothing alarming happened. The big cat was just looking for somewhere with his kind to hang out and probably get some free lunch while at it. For the following weeks, he seemed happy to eat, nap, and mate in the enclosure, seemingly having forgotten his wild habitat. But just as everyone was getting used to his presence, the tiger scaled the zoo security wall and disappeared as suddenly as he had shown up. He was never seen again. Python. This situation didn't finish as well like the cases shown before. In 2013, a python managed to get loose from a Canadian animal farm. The snake, which measured more than 4 meters, 13 feet, sneaked into the ventilation system of the house of the animal farm owner and entered into the child's bedroom. Two children were staying at the house as they were having a friend's sleepover. It wasn't until the following morning that the dad and the owner of the animal farm entered the bedroom to find the two children dead. They had both been strangled by the python. Rhesus monkeys. Admittedly, there are conflicting reports on this story even in reputable newspapers, but the basic facts go something like this. Led by a rhesus monkey named Capone, 150 to 175 rhesus monkeys escaped a Long Island zoo for several days in 1935. Most reports agree that the monkey's keeper was going about his normal cleaning duties when the monkeys made for their move. He placed a board across the moat that spanned the rhesus monkey's island and went to work. Meanwhile, the enterprising rhesus monkey simply walked across the board to freedom. Again, reports here conflict. While the Tribune said the keeper was set upon by the horde, the Evening Post played the story a bit more wholesomely. Ultimately, the zoo offered locals a free season pass, or just plain money, if they could return the missing monkeys to their home. It's unclear if all were ever returned. Gorillas. What's more trouble than a bunch of escaped monkeys? An outdated and run-down zoo enclosure filled with restless gorillas. The Los Angeles Zoo has seen its fair share of escapes, including zebras, chimps, kangaroos, and antelopes, that cunningly made a run for it in the late 1990s and early 2000s. The Los Angeles Times reported that in the span of half a decade, at least 35 animals escaped the zoo. But the most famous escape was the gorilla Evelyn. Over the years, Evelyn escaped her enclosure some 4 or 5 times. Once, she jumped onto another gorilla's back to hopping over the wall. Another time, she used some overgrown vines to pull herself out of her exhibit. She then had a full run of the zoo for an hour as TV news helicopters hovered overhead and visitors were evacuated. It seems like the Los Angeles Zoo has some renovations to make. Now, do you think animals should be kept in captivity in zoos? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.